Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Courtney Ryan. Today I'm going to be going over five things that guys do wrong when it comes to women. So if you follow me on Instagram, you might have seen me ask this on my Instagram story, and a bunch of ladies submitted responses for me. They shared their personal experiences. They really tried to give some constructive criticism. I made sure to specifically say that in no way, shape, or form is this meant to bash anybody or put anybody down or make anybody feel bad, but we're humans and sometimes we make mistakes or could do things better. So that is the point of this video, to maybe just be more aware of the things that you're doing and try to avoid them going forward. And you guys know I like to be fair on this channel, so don't you worry, there will be a video coming out as well about the things that women do wrong when it comes to men and dating as well. And as a woman, I feel like I can speak pretty honestly about that. So let's get started. Number one, and probably the most common response I got, is being too clingy and desperate. Being too needy and clingy from the very beginning can send a girl absolutely running for the hills. This is one of the worst things you can do when it comes to building attraction, and especially sexual attraction. This can also be a very big red flag in the beginning and come across as love bombing. If you guys don't know what that is, I did an entire video on games that people play when it comes to dating, so be sure to check that out. But really, it's just a huge red flag. The problem with being clingy and desperate is that you should have things going on in your life that give you purpose and fulfillment, right? And you shouldn't be relying on this girl to be the source of your happiness. And if you're coming across needy and clingy, that's probably how you're acting. You should have your own life going on and not feel the need to be with this girl or talk to this girl 24/7. It's a huge turn off when guys act like that. And I wanted to read one of the responses I got because I thought it was very well said, and it says, "Acting desperate and double, triple, quadruple texting without a response. I know it's hard to just sit and wait for a response, but for girls who are on dating apps messaging multiple guys, I know I was much more likely to keep texting a guy if I didn't feel such a huge pressure to text him back right away. Otherwise, I'd end up with 8 unanswered messages." So this is something that's very real. I've experienced this as a woman. Think of being on the other side of that and being bombarded by someone you don't even know or haven't met yet, and how much of a red flag that seems and comes across as when that person hasn't even gotten to know you. So just really be conscious of this. I know it can sting a little bit and maybe not feel the best when we don't get A, the response that we wanted, or B, a response at all, but bombarding that person and bothering them back to back to back and sending all these messages and blowing up their phone is only going to make you look bad. So from a place of caring about you, I say it because I don't want you to do that to yourself or feel like you have to do that. When you do those things, it's really going to make you look clingy and needy and desperate, and we want to avoid that at all cost. And something that I would really recommend you guys doing here is stop focusing so much solely on chasing women. When you find your purpose and your passions in life, you will not feel that need to be clingy and desperate with women ever again. So if you're someone who struggles with this, you need to figure out some things in your life that will make you in return a better partner, a better boyfriend, a better you, whatever that looks like. I think it is important to, you know, kind of figure yourself out. That needy and clingy behavior often stems from insecurity and a lack of fulfillment or purpose within your life. So once you get that area of your life sorted, or you start to work on it a little bit more, you're going to notice yourself acting a lot less clingy and desperate because you're fine on your own. Number two, I've got poor communication skills. So sadly, I think this is something that everyone is just really bad at. Being able to effectively communicate how you're feeling and what you want from your partner is incredibly important. But even if you're not necessarily together yet, being able to be a good communicator from the start is a green flag and so important. When you start seeing someone, I do think it's really important to be transparent and open about what you're looking for to make sure that you guys are both on the same page. So being able to effectively communicate that to the other person to make sure that neither one of you are wasting each other's time is a great thing. And it's totally okay to be open about your feelings and your expectations. Contrary to popular belief, this does not make you a weak person, and women actually find it incredibly attractive when you are a good communicator. And part of being a good communicator is also being a good listener, which, if we're being honest, is something that a lot of us struggle with. Think of when you're going on a date with a girl, being able to have a great conversation and interact back and forth with her and keep the conversation going makes a good date. So a good conversation is often what makes a good date. So keep that in mind when you're out on a first date with someone, or just when you're meeting someone new or interacting with someone, being able to contribute to the conversation, be a good, effective communicator, and also being able to listen is a must-have for good conversation. I had a girl girl respond to my story and say, I went on a date with a guy who sat and talked about himself for an hour and a half and didn't ask her a single question, just sat there and talked about himself. And as someone who has been on a date like that, it is such a turnoff when the other person on the date does not ask you anything and you're just sitting there asking them the questions the whole time, or they are just going crazy talking about themselves. I went on a first date with a guy this one time, and I don't know that he asked me a single question about myself. He literally sat there, talked about himself the entire time, was showing me photos on his camera roll of his like entire life. It was truly bizarre. And looking back, I just remember how much of a turnoff that was. So I don't want you guys to be like that either. So being a good communicator also means asking them questions and listening to what they say, not necessarily just being the one talking the entire time. So don't forget how important it is to listen and be self-aware when you're in situations like that. Obviously, sitting there and talking about yourself for an hour and a half is not a good look. And if you're self-aware, you're gonna know that. Communication skills are absolutely everything. If you don't have good communication with your partner or the person that you're talking to or you just met, it's never going to work out. So getting your communication skills in a good standing and really working on that is incredibly important. Number three, I have coming on too strong, and this one makes me cringe. This is also one of the most common responses I got, and to be honest, I was not surprised by that. Look, guys, I totally understand that we all have needs that need met, but coming on too strong sexually too soon is a disaster. Especially when it's before you've even built attraction or sexual attraction with the other person, it's a huge turnoff to women. It makes you look desperate. It makes you look like just a dog. It really just is not a good look for you. You really want to read the room. So being direct and being a bold guy is great. It shows confidence. It shows that you're direct and you can take control of a situation. However, when it comes to the sexual department, I do think it is important to, like I said, read the room and gauge how that other person is feeling too. You really do not want to come on too strong in this area if that other person is not giving you anything in return. My friend was on Tinder and this guy messaged her, and the first thing he said was, "Want to get pizza and F word." And I say that because I like to keep it PG on this channel. You guys know that. But if he would have just said, "Want to get pizza," that would have been fine. But she didn't even give him the time of day or respond because he made it sexual from the first message. And if the other person has made it clear that that's what they're looking for as well, okay, that's a little bit different if you're just looking for a hookup or whatever. But if that person is on there for something a little bit more serious or a relationship or whatever it is, and you don't know that, or even if you don't know that yet, it's important to just kind of be neutral and get to know them instead of coming on so sexual and strong like a caveman. And one important thing that I wanted to touch on when it comes to this is sending inappropriate photos. Men, as we know, are extremely visual, and I don't think any of you would be mad if a woman sent you a naked photo, right? It's just kind of common sense. However, if a woman doesn't know you and gets a dick pic from you, it's going to be a huge turnoff for her. So you really want to keep this in mind. Even me, I get on my Instagram, I go to my messages, and random men that I've never met before send me videos and photos of their penis, of them doing sexual things, and it is mind-blowing to me how anybody thinks that would make me like you or build attraction to you. And I try to give people the benefit of the doubt and understand different cultures and all of that as well, but do not send a girl you've never met, a stranger, a photo of your penis. Just, you heard it here first, guys. Courtney Ryan told you not to. Please stop doing this. So again, once you've built that sexual attraction with someone, I think being bold and being direct and taking the lead when it comes to this is a really great thing for a lot of people. Of course, you really want to kind of gauge how your partner feels about all of that, but understand that if you do this too soon and you come on too strong, it's going to send her running. Number four, I have not being direct / not putting in any effort. I got a ton of responses about this one as well, and mainly girls saying that they always have to plan the date or they have to ask the guy out because he's too nervous. And they said that they want the guy to plan the date. They want you to ask them out because it makes them feel sexy and it makes you look confident and decisive, and girls like that. taking the lead and being direct is so sexy. And I know a lot of you are probably gonna be confused because in the last point I just said, don't come on too strong. But I think coming on too strong sexually is very different than being direct and taking the lead in the beginning of a relationship. So that's kind of where pursuing comes into play. And we wanna be pursuing someone that we like. Of course, we don't wanna be chasing. Chasing and pursuing are two totally different things. But that pursuing factor is incredibly important and super sexy to women. If you're constantly letting your insecurities or being nervous keep you from asking a girl out, you've already lost. So I would highly recommend you just ask her out. If she says no, she says no. It's good practice anyway. And I know that, you know, when you've been rejected so many times, it can sting, it sucks, but you'll never know unless you ask. So you really want to ask her out and then also plan the date. And I got a lot of messages from you guys saying that you are tired of pursuing, you are tired of planning the dates, you are tired of asking people out. And I get it, especially if the girl isn't giving you anything in return, which to that I would say you should not be wasting your time. All of those things should be reciprocated to you as well. But for a first date, if you see a girl and you want to take her out, I would highly recommend asking her out. Don't wait for her to ask you because I guarantee it's not going to happen. So ask her out, and then I would also really recommend just planning the first date. You don't have to plan every date for the rest of your life, but just plan that first date, take the lead, be confident, take her out, and I promise you it's going to be attractive to her. And on the topic of dates, it doesn't have to be a crazy expensive date. It doesn't have to even be elaborate. It can just be, hey, let's meet at this coffee shop at 2 p.m. on Sunday. Seriously, it can be as simple as that. It doesn't have to be crazy. So understand that asking her out, planning the date, being direct, and taking the lead is a huge turn on. Pursuing a girl shows that you care and you're willing to put in the effort instead of just texting her at 11 p.m. on a Wednesday, hey, you up? Come on, guys. Anything worth having takes a little bit of work, in my opinion, so I think pursuing is something that is necessary, and every relationship requires effort. You can't just go in and think everything is going to fall into your lap or the other person is going to do everything for you. So again, like I mentioned, she should be putting in the time, effort, and energy that you are putting in as well. So if that's not happening for you, maybe it's time to move on. But I just want you guys to know that in the beginning, asking her out and planning the date and being confident and secure and masculine is attractive. And number five, the last one on my list, is dishonesty. So this one kind of goes back to what I mentioned earlier about expectations, but I wanted to elaborate a little bit on that here. Be honest with yourself and make sure that you're being authentic with you and also with the dating process. Authentic relationships do not require you to abandon who you are or to pretend to be someone that you're not. So a little example I have here is maybe going on dates. So maybe on the first date, you want to impress her. You want to woo her and make her think that you have a ton of money, you're very successful. So you take her to a 5-star restaurant that is super expensive, even though you're broke. Do not do that. Number one, never sacrifice your financial security to get a girl to like you. We absolutely don't want to do that ever. Number two, you're clearly not being authentic or genuine in that situation because you're just doing something to get her to like you. It's okay to show up as the best version of yourself, but you don't want to be showing up as someone that you are absolutely not. This isn't honest to that other person, but it's also not honest with yourself. You really want to be honest and authentic so that you find people that are attracted to the real you and not someone that you're pretending to be, because let's be honest, you're not going to be able to keep that up forever and you shouldn't want to. And not even just when it comes to money. I think a lot of guys go into a date so focused on if that other girl likes them, so much so that they don't even stop to think, do I like this girl? Am I being my real self? Would she even be attracted to the real me? So you want to kind of shift that to think about, do I even like her? Instead of going in with that scarcity mindset, thinking I have to get her to like me and I will do whatever it takes to get that. So we want to avoid that. It's not authentic, it's not genuine, and it's not honest. The truth is that you don't need to do this, and a girl that is right for you will not expect you to, especially if you don't have the money or the means for it. So again, be honest with yourself, be honest with that other person. Don't pretend to be something that you're not. You really want to show up as the real you and not put on this big facade to get someone to like you that doesn't even like who you really are. And another little point with dishonesty is just making sure that your words and your actions match. I got a lot of messages from girls saying that the guys they're seeing will say one thing and then completely do something else. And I've been in that situation before, and it's incredibly frustrating. It is so sexy when a guy says he's gonna do something and he does it. You really wanna follow through and just be a guy of integrity. And a guy with integrity is not dishonest, and his actions match his words. And remember, you are what you do, not what you say you'll do. So keep that in mind for everything in your life, and specifically when it comes to dating. So guys, that is all I have for five major things that guys do wrong with women. Again, not meant to bash anybody or put anybody down. This is just meant to be helpful and some things that you should maybe keep in mind going forward to get the most out of your dating experience and have some success with women. So if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to be in the loop for when I release new content. Let me know down in the comments below some things that you think women do wrong when it comes to dating. Again, I'm going to be doing a video all about that. If you follow me on Instagram, I'll probably ask on my story and have you guys respond. So if you want to participate, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Courtney Christine Ryan. I love interacting with all of you guys on there on my stories as well. As always, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.